Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again on the lecture on the GATE question paper, solution for the GATE question paper in Mechanical Engineering subject. So, in my discussion, I will be discussing questions from thermodynamics, thermal engineering, heat and mass transfer, and fluid mechanics and machines. And this is lecture number 6. The subject is engineering thermodynamics. We take a few questions from the engineering thermodynamics, and I will give the solution as well as the discussion wherever required. I give the discussion. The first question from 2009 question paper: a compressor undergoes reversible steady flow process. The gas at the inlet and the outlet of the compressor is designated as state 1 and state 2. The potential and kinetic energies are neglected. The following notations are used: V is the specific volume, P is the pressure of the gas. The specific work required to be supplied to the compressor for this compression process. So, the device is compressor. The working device is compressor. So, it is a flow process. It is a flow process. For flow process, there are two types of compressor: reciprocating compressor, which is considered as the reciprocating compressor. We may consider as an open system reciprocating compressor, and this is rotary compressor. So steady flow process, rotary compressor. For reciprocating compressor, the work done is integral PdV. For rotary compressor, the work done is integral VdP. So, the difference you have to understand: for reciprocating compressor, integral PdV, and for rotary compressor, the work done is integral VdP. So, the answer is integral VdP between 1 and 2. So, among the given answer, integral VdP is the answer. And the heat and work are intensive properties, extensive properties, point function and path function. First of all, they are not point function. As they are not point function, they are not when they are point function, they may be properties, whether the intensive properties or extensive properties. Heat and work are not point function. They are not intensive property or extensive property. They are path function. So, heat and work depending on the path followed by the system. The content of a well insulated tank are heated by a resistor of 23 ohm in which 10 amps current is flowing. Consider the tank along with its content as a thermodynamic system. The work done by the system and the heat transfer to the system are positive. Work done by the system and heat transfer to the system are positive. This is the sign convention. The rates of heat and work and the change in internal energy during this process in kilowatt. So, this is well insulated tank. So, the insulated tank Q equal to 0. Well insulated tank, the content of the well insulated tank heated by a resistor. There is electrical heating with a resistor of 23 ohms where the current flow is 10 amps. So, the we have to calculate the amount of work done and change in internal energy. So, the Q equal to 0. So, because it is insulated, Q equal to 0. There are two terms of the Q equal to 0, A and D. Among the two, which is correct? The A or D. So, D is correct. We will see how. The power is W equal to I square into R. So, 10 square into 23 equal to 2300 watts, which is 2.3 kilowatts. So, as the tank is insulated, Q equal to 0. From the first law of thermodynamics, Q equal to W plus delta U. So, Q equal to 0, 2.3, W equal to 2.3 and delta U. So, delta U is minus 2.3 and W equal to 2.3, Q equal to 0. That is the answer. Q equal to 0, W equal to 2.3, delta U equal to minus 2.3. So, just applying the first law of thermodynamics, you can find the answer. This is from the 2011 question paper. And again, another question from 2011 question paper. A pump handling a liquid raises its pressure from 1 bar to 30 bar. So, from 1 bar to 30 bar, take the density of the liquid as 990 kilogram per meter cube. The isentropic work done by the pump in kilojoules per kilogram is, there are 4 options, 0.1, 0.3, 2.5 and 2.93 kilojoules per kilogram. And the work done for the pump, so W equal to VDP. So, integral VDP, so we integrate, so 1 by rho into P2 minus P1. So, density of the liquid is taken as 990, so P2 minus P1 is 30 minus 1 bar into 100 to convert bar into kilopascal divided by 990 equal to 2.93 kilojoules per kilogram. The answer is D, 2.93 kilojoules per kilogram. And the next question from the 2016 question paper, which of the following statements are true with respect to heat and work? Heat and work, they are boundary phenomena, they are exact differential and they are path function. So, heat and work, they are crossing the boundary of the system. So, they are boundary phenomena. First statement is correct. They are exact differential, that is not correct. So, heat and work, they are inexact differential. So, that is why we write del W, del Q. So, they are inexact differential and they are path function, that is also true. So, heat and work are boundary phenomena and path function. The answer is 1 and 3. 1 and 3 are true with respect to the, from among the 3 statements, 1 and 3 are true. A mass M of a perfect gas, pressure P1 and volume V1 undergoes isothermal process. So, isothermal process, the final pressure is P2 and the volume is V2. The work done on the system considered as positive. Work done on the system is positive. So, remember, normally work done by the system is positive. There is a change in the sign convention. Work done on the system considered as positive. If R is the gas constant, T is the temperature, then the work done in the process. So, there are 4 answers. P1 V1 logarithmic of V2 by V1 minus P1 V1 logarithmic of P1 by P2. RT into logarithmic of V1 by V2 and minus MRT into logarithmic of P2 by P1. So, the work done for isothermal compression process equal to W equal to. So, this is compression process. So, for this process, work done equal to minus of P1 V1 logarithmic of P1 by P2. The answer is B. An engine operates, this is from the 2018 question paper. So, an engine operates on the reversible cycle as shown in the figure. So, it is working on the reversible cycle. So, the work output from the engine in kilojoules per cycle is, you have to find the answer. So, we look at the cycle. So, volume is taken in x-axis meter cube. Pressure is given in y-axis in kilopascal. So, the process is here. The pressure is 400 kilopascal. At the top, the highest pressure is 650 kilopascal and the volume, minimum volume is 2 meter cube and maximum volume is 2.5 meter cube. So, work done for the, in the PV diagram, work done equal to the area of the PV diagram. So, work done is the area of the PV diagram, W equal to half into B into H. So, half into B is 2.5 minus 2, H is 650 minus 400. So, the answer is 62.5 kilojoules per cycle. So, the work done per cycle is 62.5 kilojoules per cycle. And 1 kg of air, so this is from the 2019 question paper, 1 kg of air is compressed at constant temperature of 150 degree Celsius until the volume is halved. Considering gas constant R equal to 0.287 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin for air, magnitude of heat rejected in kilojoules in the compression process. So, this is isothermal compression process. So, V2 by V1 is given as 0.5. So, V1, V2 equal to 0.5 times of V1. So, the volume is half of the, so final volume is half of the initial volume. So, V2 by V1 equal to 0.5 for isothermal process, heat transfer equal to work done. So, which is MRT1 into logarithmic of V2 by V1. So, substituting 1 into 0.287 into 150 plus 273. Into logarithmic of 0.5 equal to minus 84.15 kilojoules. So, why there is a minus sign? It because it is compression process. So, the answer is 84.15. The work done for the compression process is 84.15 kilojoules. A vertical cylinder, so this is from the 1993 question paper, a vertical cylinder with a freely floating piston contains 0.1 kg of air at 1.2 bar and a small electrical resistor. The resistor is wired to an external 12 volt battery. When a current of 1.5 amps passes through the resistor for 90 seconds, the piston suits a volume of 0.01 meter cube. Assume the piston and cylinder are insulated. Air behaves as an ideal gas, Cv equal to 700 joules per kilogram Kelvin. Find the resistance temperature of the air. So, the change in the volume for the piston cylinder arrangement. So, dV equal to 0.01 meter cube. Mass equal to 1 kilogram. So, mass equal to 0.1 kilogram. So, M is mass, 1.1 kilogram. And the pressure is 1.2 bar. So, pressure is 1.2 bar. So, Q is 0 for vertical insulated cylinder. So, resistor, when the current passes through the air, so the piston sweeps a volume. So, it is insulated, piston cylinder are insulated, that is the condition given, Q equal to 0 for insulated cylinder. PDB work done. So, WS, that is PDB work done by the system, WS equal to P into DV. So, pressure is 1.2, that is 120 kilopascal into 0.01 equal to 1.2 kilojoules. And the voltage battery is 12 volts and the current flow is 1.5 amps. And the work done by the passing current through the electrical resistor, V into I into T. So, 12 into 1.5 into 90 seconds, this is 1620 watts. So, this is equal to minus of 1.60 kilowatts. So, why there is a minus sign? The electric current is given, work input given. So, work is given from outside, electrical current. So, it is minus negative work. The piston is reciprocating. So, this is the positive work. There is a change in volume, positive change in the volume 0.01. This is positive work, this is negative work. So, from the first law of thermodynamics, del Q minus del W equal to du. So, del Q equal to du plus del W. So, substituting del Q equal to 0, del W is 1.2 minus of 1.62 equal to mcv into dt. That is what du. So, the difference is 0.42 equal to 0.1 into 0.7 into dt. So, change in temperature equal to 0.42 divided by 0.07 equal to 6 degree Celsius. That is the answer. The change in temperature, find the rise in temperature of the air, delta T equal to 6 degree Celsius. So, this is from, this question is from 2005 question paper. So, nitrogen at initial state of 10 bar, 1 meter cube and 300 Kelvin is expanded isothermally to a final volume of 2 meter cube. The PVT relationship is given as P plus A by V square into V equal to RT, where A is greater than 0. The final pressure is, by final pressure, there are 4 options. A will be slightly less than 5 bar, will be B, option B, will be slightly more than 5 bar, option C, will be exactly 5 bar, option D cannot be ascertained in the absence of value of A. So, the 4 options, the correct answer we will find out. So, the equation is P plus A by V square into V equal to RT. We substitute the initial conditions. So, P equal to 10 bar, which is 1000 kilopascal, A by V equal to specific volume equal to 1 meter cube, initial volume is 1 meter cube into 1 meter cube again equal to R. R for nitrogen is 0.2969. 2969, that is molecular universal gas constant divided by the molecular weight, it is 0.2969 into temperature is 300. So, from the first equation, we can find A equal to minus of 910.93. Now, for the final condition, you take the same equation, substitute. So, P minus A equal to 910.93 divided by 2 square into 2 equal to 0.2969 into 300. There is no change in temperature, it is isothermal process, there is no change in the temperature. So, initial temperature T1 equal to T2, so 300 equal to 300. So, we calculate the pressure from here, which is 500 kilopascal, which is 5 bar. So, the answer is, the pressure will be finally, final pressure will be exactly 5 bar. That is the correct answer. And this is from 2006 question paper. A 100 watt electrical bulb was switched on in a 2.5 meter, 3 meter by 3 meter size thermally insulated room having a temperature of 20 degree Celsius. The room temperature at the end of 24 hours will be 321 degree Celsius, 341 degree Celsius, 450 degree Celsius and 470 degree Celsius. There are four options available. We will calculate. Density of the air, rho A equal to Pa by R into Ta, from the perfect gas equation. So, pressure, atmosphere pressure is 101.325 divided by R value is 0.287. Ta is 20 degree Celsius, so 293. So, this is 1.2 kilogram per meter cube. So, heat transfer to the room. So, rho A into V, that is the mass of the air. Density into volume is the mass of the air into Cv into T minus Ta. So, that is equal to P into T. So, the electrical bulb, power of the electrical bulb in the time taken for burning, for illumination. So, rho A equal to 1.2, volume of the room is 2.5 into 3 into 3. And the Cv equal to 718 for air. That is also constant we have to take. And the temperature difference T minus 20. Air temperature, initial temperature is 20 degrees Celsius. T minus 20 equal to the P, power of the bulb, 100. So, it is illuminated. It is burning for 24 hours into 3600. So, hours to second conversion, 3600. So, solving this equation, we will get T minus 20 equal to 445.7 degrees Celsius. Or T equal to 465.7 degree Celsius. So, 465.7 degree Celsius equal to 470 degree Celsius. So, the answer is 470 degree Celsius. In a steady state, steady flow process taking place in a device with a single inlet and a single outlet. The work done per unit mass flow rate is given by W equal to minus integral between inlet and the outlet VdP. Where V is the specific volume, P is the pressure. The expression for W is given above. So, for the flow work, the work done for a flow device, steady flow device equal to minus integral VdP. So, the equation is applicable for 1, is valid only if the process both reversible and isothermal. 2, is valid only if the process is both reversible and adiabatic. C, is valid for any process, and D, incorrect, it must be W equal to integral PdV. So, for flow process, integral VdP, integral VdP is the work done. So, the last option D is straight away dropped. So, among the three, so the work done steady flow process for the work done is, it is the equation for any of the processes. So, it is flow process, steady flow process, application of steady flow energy equation. So, it is valid for any process is the answer. This is from the 2008 question paper. And this is from 2009 question paper. A frictionless piston cylinder device contains gas initially at 0.8 megapascal and 0.013 meter cube. It expands quasi-statically at constant temperature to a final volume of 0.03 meter cube. The work output in kilojoules during this process will be, there are four options, 8.32, 12.0, 554.67, 8320.0. So, it is isothermal process, isothermal expansion process. So, we are given initial pressure, initial volume, final volume. So, for isothermal process, again work done equal to P1 V1 logarithmic of V2 by V1. So, P1 is 0.8 megapascal, 800 kilopascal, V1 equal to 0.015 meter cube, into logarithmic of 0.03 by 0.015 equal to 8.317 kilojoules. So, the answer is 8.32 kilojoules. The next question from the 2010 question paper, a monoatomic ideal gas, gamma equal to 1.67, molecular weight equal to 40, is compressed adiabatically from 0.1 megapascal, 300 Kelvin, to 0.2 megapascal. The universal gas constant is 8.314 kilojoules per kilomole Kelvin. The work of compression of the gas in kilojoules per kilogram is, there are four options, 29.7 kilojoules per kilogram, 19.9 kilojoules per kilogram, 13.3 kilojoules per kilogram, and 0 kilojoules per kilogram. We will solve the problem. For adiabatic process, so T2 equal to T1 into P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus by gamma, which is 300 into 0.2 divided by 0.1. So, final pressure is 0.2 megapascal, initial pressure is 0.1 megapascal. So, to the power 1.67 minus 1 divided by 1.67, solving this equation, T2 equal to 396.18 Kelvin. And the work done for adiabatic expansion, adiabatic compression. So adiabatic compression process, W equal to Cv into T2 minus T1. So the Cv is the specific heat at constant volume. So from the given data, Cv equal to Ru by M into gamma minus 1. So Ru by M equal to the R gas constant into gamma minus 1 into T2 minus T1. So 8.314 divided by 40 into 1.61 minus 1 equal to into 396.18 minus 300 equal to 29.83 kilojoules. So the answer is 29.7 kilojoules per kilogram. And this is the next question from the 2014 question paper. 1.5 kg of water is in saturated liquid state at 2 bar, where Vf specific volume of the liquid is 0.001061 meter cube per kilogram. Uf internal energy 504 kilojoules per kilogram. Hf enthalpy 505 kilojoules per kilogram. The heat is added at constant pressure process till the temperature of the water reaches 400 degrees Celsius, where the specific volume is 1.5493 meter cube per kilogram. Internal energy is 2967 kilojoules per kilogram and the enthalpy is 3277 kilojoules per kilogram. The heat added in kilojoules in the process. So it is constant volume heating from the initial condition to the final condition. So for constant pressure process, Q equal to M into H2 minus H1, which is 1.5 into 3277 minus 505 equal to 4158 kilojoules. So the amount of heat added equal to 4158 kilojoules is the answer. So this is from 2014 question paper. And 2015 question paper, a mixture of ideal gases has the following composition by mass: nitrogen 60%, oxygen 30%, CO2 10%. If the universal gas constant is 8314 joules per kilomole Kelvin, the characteristic gas constant of the mixer in kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin is. So we take this table. We have three gases: CO2, N2, and O2. Molecular weight of each gas: CO2 44, N2 nitrogen 28, oxygen 32. So the gas constant R equal to 8314 divided by the molecular weight. So calculating for CO2, it is 188.9. And N2 it is 296.9 and O2 259.8. So the gas constant of the gaseous mixer, so R equal to MCO2 RCO2 plus MN2 RN2 plus MO2 RO2 divided by total mass MCO2 plus MN2 plus MO2. We substitute MCO2 is 10% 0.1 into 188.9 plus MN2 is 60% 0.6 into 296.1. And MO2 is 30%, 0.3 into 259.8 divided by 0.1 plus 0.6 plus 0.3 equal to 1 in the denominator. The answer is 274.97 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So the answer in kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin is 0.27497. So we have calculated in joules per kilogram Kelvin. So in kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, 0.27497 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And this is from 2016 question paper. An ideal gas undergoes reversible process in which pressure varies linearly with volume. The conditions at the start subscript 1 and the end subscript 2 of the process with the usual notations P1 equal to 100 kilopascal, V1 equal to 0.2 meter cube, P2 equal to 200 kilopascal, V2 equal to 0.1 meter cube. The magnitude of work required for the process in kilojoules is. So this is the PV diagram. The PV pressure volume hold the linear relationship. So we are given P1 equal to 100 kilopascal. So P1 equal to 100 kilopascal. V1 equal to 0.1 meter cube, 0.2 meter cube. So V1 equal to 0.2 meter cube. P2 equal to 200 kilopascal. And V2 equal to 0.1 meter cube. So this is a compression process. Magnitude of work done for the process. So work done equal to area of the triangle 1 to A plus area under the line A1. So area of the triangle 1 to A equal to half BH, half into V1 minus V2 into P2 minus P1 in plus P1 into V1 minus V2. So that is the volume of the rectangle. So 1 by 2 into V1 minus V2. So solving this equation, we have common term is V1 minus V2 is a common term. So we simplify this equation, the equation will become 1 by 2 V1 minus V2 into P2 plus P1. So you take, substitute the values 0.5 into 0.2 minus 0.1 plus 200 plus 100 equal to 15 kilojoules. The answer. So the answer is 15 kilojoules. That is the answer. This is from 2016 question paper. Next question is from 2018. Air is held inside a non-insulated cylinder using piston of mass m equal to 25 kilogram, area A equal to 100 centimeter square, and the stoppers of negligible area as shown in the figure. So you have the figure. The initial pressure Pi and temperature of air inside the cylinder are 200 kilopascal and 400 degree Celsius respectively. The ambient pressure Pa equal to Pa and Ta are 100 kilopascal and 27 degree Celsius respectively. The temperature of the air inside the cylinder at which the piston will begin to move is, we have to calculate the temperature. So we are given a piston of mass 25 kilogram of area 100 centimeter square. So piston, it has a mass. So due to the weight of the piston, so it is giving a downward force. And the initial pressure inside the gas, so which is 200 kilopascal and 400 degree Celsius. So this is giving a force, pressure. There is a force due to the pressure. Pressure which is acting in the upward direction. So the atmospheric air is acting in the top. So the force on the downward moving, the force acting downward equal to the pressure, the force due to the atmospheric air and the weight of the piston. And the force in the upward direction is the force due to the pressure of the air inside the cylinder. So when the force on the outside is more than the force inside, automatically the piston will move upward direction, in the downward direction. That is what the answer. You have to find out the temperature at which the air temperature, when it is reduces for less than 400, it will move down. The piston will move down. So we'll see pressure acting on the air. So P2, pressure acting on the air. So the P2 equal to Pa plus mg into A. So the pressure is, so this is initial pressure. What is the final pressure acting? This is Pa plus mg into A, mg divided by A. Mg is the weight divided by the area, that is the pressure. So Pa is 100 kilopascal, which is 1 lakh pascal. So m equal to 25 kilogram, 9.81 divided by area equal to 100 centimeter square, which is 110⁻⁴. So this is also pascal. So this is 124525 pascal, which is 124.525 kilopascal. So the pressure acting right now, the pressure acting here is 124.525 kilopascal. Before piston movement, V1 equal to V2. So it is in the position. So there is no change in the volume. So the two forces are balanced. So it is in the same movement. So V1 equal to V2. So this is a constant volume process. For constant volume process, T2 equal to T1 into P2 by P1. Which is 673 into 124.525 divided by 200 equal to 419 Kelvin or 146 degree Celsius. So, the temperature of the air inside the cylinder at which the piston will begin to move is 146 degree Celsius. That means, when the air temperature, the initial temperature is 400, when the temperature reduces to 146 degree Celsius, the piston will move. So what is at what condition you listen here? It is non-insulated cylinder. So from the body of the cylinder, so there is heat loss to the atmosphere because the atmosphere temperature is 27 degrees Celsius. The air temperature inside the tank is 400 degrees Celsius. So the air will lose its heat energy to the atmosphere because of the temperature difference. So the air temperature will decrease. When the air temperature reaches 146 degrees Celsius, the piston will start to move down. So, that is what the question. So, this is from 2018 question paper. And 1 mole of H2 gas occupies a rigid container with a capacity of 1000 liters and temperature is raised from 27 degrees Celsius to 37 degrees Celsius. The changes in pressure of the gas assuming ideal gas behavior is dash. You have to take R equal to 8.314 joules per kilomole Kelvin, and this is from 2019 question paper. So, N equal to 1, number of moles equal to 1, dT, change in temperature is 37 minus 27 equal to 10 degree, volume is 1000 liters equal to 1 meter cube. For perfect gas, PV equal to NRU into T. So, differentiate this equation, V into dP. So, V into dP equal to, so because it is a constant volume, rigid container, there is no change in the volume, there is only change in the pressure because of the change in temperature. So P into V dP equal to N into R into DT. So DP change in pressure is 1 into N equal to number of moles equal to 1. RU universal gas constant is 8.314 into DT equal to 10 divided by volume equal to 1 meter cube. 1000 liter equal to 1 meter cube. So 83.14 kilopascal. So the answer is 83.14 Pascal. That is what the change in the pressure. So you stop here. We stop here. This is there. Thank you for watching. And you can please post your comments on the YouTube video box. So for it will be useful for me to improve the video. You subscribe the YouTube channel. I have uploaded more than 200 videos on the thermal engineering subject, heat transfer, thermodynamics, for benefit of the learners. And I have also uploaded various question paper, the solution for gate question paper. So it will be useful for your learning and passing the gate examination. And you can write to my mail ID or WhatsApp to my number for additional information or doubt in the presentation. So thank you for watching once again. We'll meet again.